Training by operator. FlexiCapture can utilize machine learning training, which actually analyzes the invoice and finds anchor text strings and separators, check marks, etc. By finding these anchor elements, the machine learning process dynamically calculates the correct location of the field that was misrecognized. It uses verification operator input to accomplish this. Let's see how training by operator, or automatic training as it's called, can be done on our web verification station. So this FlexiCapture for Invoices project has already been uploaded to the server, and I've already loaded up a batch in the web scan station and sent that in, so I'm ready to do verification. So we'll go to the web verification station, and we've got a task ready for verification. And the invoice date is not being captured correctly out of the box. So I'll actually rubber band the correct location. And let's go ahead and deal with this line item error. I'll just say it's valid. And we'll go to the next error. And once again, the invoice date needs to be corrected. I'll rubber band. And I'll now go to the third document, and the same problem is happening here. There we go. I'll rubber band the proper area, make a little adjustment here. There we go. And now I will check on my line items. And I can now send this batch in. And the batch has been sent back to FlexiCapture for recognition, rather for export at this stage after verification. When an operator corrects the location of a field during verification, that image is added to a vendor-specific training batch. And we can take a quick look at that. I'll click on View, Open Field Extraction Training Batches. And this training batch actually contains the three images where positional changes were made. If we open this up, we can see the three images. And if we want to look at one of the images, we can see that the date was actually captured correctly right here. And we're performing normalization. So let's go ahead and close the field extraction training batch. Let's go back to our working batches. So now let's scan another batch. I'll go to the web scanning station. And I'll add images from a folder. The first batch we processed was with three images. This time, I'll select four images, and I'll go ahead and send them in. And we'll go to the web verification station, and we can select which role we want to log in, and the verification operator role will work fine, but I'm used to working as a senior verification operator. And we'll get the task. And now we've got four documents. One thing that we can see is that the date was actually recognized correctly, and we just have a line item issue. Let's go to the second document. The line items just need to be verified. Sure enough, the date got located in the correct location there, and in the correct location there. And this fourth document is a document that's never been seen before. In other words, it wasn't in the training batch. So it almost got it. Sometimes an additional adjustment needs to be made. I can just delete this location, and I'll rubber band. And this too will be added to the training batch. So we'll go from three documents to four, and there's kind of an iterative learning that goes on with the training batch, and so it will come to know exactly where this data is. We can return to our project and actually export the trained Flexi layout. And I've already done that. So if I go to my desktop, there is the location where I exported. And we can take a look at how this machine learning is actually visible. The logic is understandable and visible to us. So if I look at one of these images and I match it, I can see my tree of hypothesis. And I can see a variety of static text elements. These are those anchors that I was referring to before. And it may or may not find all of them depending on how the nature of your invoices from a given vendor. If they vary a lot, maybe some of these anchors are found and maybe some aren't found. But from here, we can go and look at our actual fields group. And in this fields group, I can see the invoice date. And I can also see the logic that was used relative to those anchor elements. So if I click on relations, I can see all these different relations above this, below that, to the right of this, below that. And when those all add up, combined, it will come up with a rectangle that shows the location of the target data. So I'll hit Control A and I'll select all of these relations. I'll manually select all these relations, and that's how we can actually see the target data, right, target area right there. But also, it's not just looking for a certain target area, but it's also looking for data that comports with a character count projection and different alphabets. This is truly a powerful feature because we can see what decisions the machine learning algorithm made, and we can make adjustments either to the relations or the alphabets or the character count or other adjustments if we felt we needed to.